Now, Sinatra's back. He's older. They have to get him a new toupee. It's silver. He's still touring. He's still going strong throughout the 80s. He's playing venues. He's getting honors, Lifetime Achievement Awards, Lifetime Grammy Award. And then the 90s come. And Frank is still touring. And I remind you, he's 70. He just can't stop. The audiences want them. And I have to confess, you know, I saw Sinatra in the 90s. I was 21, and it was a very good year. I saw Sinatra in 1992. And it was a pretty big deal for me because I had developed an appreciation for this music right around that time. I was in college, I was studying music, and I was contemplating going to law school. And I really understood and appreciated what Sinatra could do with a song. So I saw him, and yeah, he was heavier. Yeah, he had lost some of those high notes. And even sometimes he lost some of the words. There were teleprompters. Okay, fine. But you know what? It was still Sinatra. And it was still magic. And it's interesting how things in life kind of are focal points. Because that love that I had for this music and that appreciation and respect that I had for Sinatra the musician stuck with me. He went on, he kept touring. He did duets in 1994. The first and only album that he ever did that went triple platinum. So I guess he was doing something, right? And I kept digging Sinatra. And I'm pretty lucky that I kept digging Sinatra. Because you see, if it wasn't for Sinatra, this lovely lady here in the front row, my wife Diana, and these two beautiful girls right here, Ellen and Amadea, believe it or not, they probably wouldn't be here. And I'll tell you why. In 1998, at 82 years of age, Frank Sinatra had a heart attack, and he died. I was a public defender. I was working down in Fort Lauderdale, fresh out of law school, defending criminal cases. And I was still performing out live, playing in bars and country clubs and nightclubs, because I still love this stuff. And I got a call. I'll never forget it. I was painting my new condo I had just moved into, and I got a call the day Sinatra died from a jazz club in Fort Lauderdale, O'Hara's. And they asked me if I would come down and I would do a Sinatra show, a tribute. And I said, of course. And it was that night, after my set, as I was waiting to get paid for that night's work, that I met this beautiful woman. She didn't want anything to do with me, of course. She kept trying to pass me off on her friends. And I was, you know, clueless to that fact. I thought she liked me. So I got her number, her work number. But like Sinatra, I was persistent. And I've never looked back. I love you, baby. I'd like to close this show with a song that I think sums up the life of Sinatra. It's from a record called September of My Years, and they were very, very good years for Sinatra. I want to thank the Mineola Civic Center for hosting this event. I want to thank you all for coming out and braving this weather. I hope that you'll go home and you'll pull out those old Sinatra records. Because this is 100 years of Sinatra. December 12th, 2015 marks 100 years of this man. He's been gone since 98 and we're still talking about him. And there's more to come, because the best is yet to come.
Mm-hmm. It was a very good year. It was a very good year for small town girls and soft summer nights. We'd hide from the lights on the village green. When I was 17, when I was 21, it was a very was a very good year for city girls who lived up the stair with all that perfumed hair, and it came undone when I was 21. It was a very good year. It was a very good year for blue-blooded girls of independent means. We'd ride in limousines. Their chauffeurs would drive. When I was 35, but now the days grow short. I'm in the autumn of the year, and now I think of my life as vintage wine from fine old cakes, from the brim to the dregs. It poured sweet and clear. It was a very good year.
Thank you. Would you all like to see more of this at the Civic Center? All right, let's make that happen. Thank you for coming, ladies and gentlemen. Be safe.